Hello, tango friends. Welcome to Patricio and Eva's tango class. Today is the last class of this series. We are planning on changing it. So I think we are going to start a new series next week. We go for the fundamentals of tango,
we
right?
Go back to basics.
Back to basics.
Yeah. That it is. Back to basics, but with a perspective, with an advanced perspective.
Correct.
So that's why we go back to basics.
But today is the last class from this series, and today we're going to work in Giros with Sacadas. Yes?
Yes. Today we finish the advanced tango figures
correct.
With what I sometimes call the tango figures factory, because this turn is the base for an endless combination of figures and elements. Mm-hmm. Today we're going to learn the structure of a turn with sacadas of 8 steps, so we can turn for an entire phrase.
Perfect. So, there you have it. Let's start.
Let's do.
Yes. So the idea of this is that every step of the turn we are going to do, you are going to see a different position. Okay? All of them are different. So, because of it, then you can plug in other elements that you recognize if you recognize the position you are at that particular time. So that's what is our goal today, to understand that every step we are doing around our partner
is a unique position. Yes, from 1 to 6. These are 6
yes.
unique positions. 7 and 8 is a repetition of position 1 and position 2. So we're going to refer as each step as positions, not as the steps themselves, because like you well said, they are is the chronological order of the steps, but they're also images of positions that we have to remember, because of that depends the ramifications of the movement. They follow thus a traditional turn or a traditional molinete. The lead will not do a step back. He will go forward side, in a specific way.
Yeah. And not right now, later in the class, I will give some tips for the follows in one particular moment of the molinete, okay? That I know that most people usually have problems with. So I will give you advice about that, okay?
Very nice.
Yes.
So, should we show the first 4? I would like to, I swear I turn it on.
Well, maybe I turn it on and turn it off.
Maybe, I don't know. I shall
okay.
set off.
Okay. The blue light is on.
And now
I
you're
can
ready.
Be heard clearly. Yes.
Yes.
If we look especially good tonight and you notice, this studio is expanding. Look how big our studio. We go from here all the way to here. And that is thanks to a brand new equipment, state of the art, that we got thanks to our friend Wesley Kronik. Wesley is one of our sponsors in this studio, and he has contributed in many ways with equipment and feedback and
yes.
with information. And so today we are using for the first time a brand new camera, professional level, and it makes it look especially bright, I think, huh? Especially sharp. And very wide. We've got so much space now. I guess kind of like we can run from one end to another.
Yeah, thank you, Wesley, so much. This
yes.
is really great. We love it.
Fantastic.
Yes.
I'm
going to
play so much with all of this.
So,
yes. I would like to divide the step on in 3 parts. 1, 2, 3, that would be the first part. 4, 5, 6, and then 7, 8.
Okay.
That's how we're going to learn it. And we're going to learn them beginning from a cross. So the lead takes his partner to the cross. And from here, you will lead the follow into a front ocho. It is important that you lead her 45 degrees away from you, or if you are considering that you are standing straight in a circle and you have 12 o'clock in front of you, you need to lead your partner towards 3 o'clock. 3 p.m. is right here, and this gives you the possibility to slide your foot and advance forward. Position one. The follow goes to the side step. I cross my right leg, and I touch her right foot with my right foot. Mm-hmm. Then the follow pivots and begins her back step. I pivot, and I go side step, touching my partner's foot from the inside. Nice. My big toe goes against her big toe. And from now, we're going to call this the end. This in itself is
plenty to start with.
Plenty to start with. The ramifications and possibilities of playfulness and dancing around this movement are very broad. Mm-hmm. So you can dance for months out of this. Shall we do this again?
Oh, I see what's happening. You don't have battery.
I don't have battery.
No. Sorry. Yeah.
Okay.
Obviously, we forgot to charge that one. Well, we are going to use mine then. We can use my microphone. That's good. We can pass it along to you and to me. What about that? Mine is fully charged.
But now. Now, we will do it together.
Okay.
The follow goes to the cross. I first unwind her, make a pivot, and advance her towards 3 o'clock. And that gives me the opportunity to put my left foot in front of her left foot. Left foot to left foot. She pivots and goes side. I move now across. My right foot is touching inner part of her foot. Pivot. I touch again her big toe or the inside of her foot. Then cross back, she comes into a sandwich. We pivot. And this. We'll do it again. Take your partner to the cross. You could cross behind if you like. Unwind her, lead her forward. See this triangle position in the floor? 3 feet on the floor, make a triangle. 1, 2, 3. See those 3 feet? Equilateral triangle. This is very important. Forward. Cross. The follow is on a side step. Back. She goes, I go side. Sandwich her. Forward. Front ocho. And then resolution. Let's dance.
Thank you.
Tenés que venir hasta mí para que te escuchen. Come to me so they can hear you.
Hola, mi amor. Here I am in front of you once again.
Good.
Okay, so this was 1, 2, and 3, right?
Yes.
From 8, I lead my partner towards 3 o'clock. They follow counter bodies. She pivots side, pivots back, right? So I enter 1, cross my body, because the cross body leads her to pass me, then cross my leg, then I continue rotating, pivot her and stop her so she doesn't pick up this foot, and then you sandwich that from the outside. You reach out, like you're gonna grab it, sandwich it, cross back. Because we're doing just 1, 2, and 3, right? We're doing 1, 2, 3. I stop before I put my foot out. So that means I have extension, extension, so I can reach out to her, extension. I grab from the outside. Look how I keep my heel off the ground. Then sandwich, cross back. This in itself, you can hold this back. This in itself is a figure. And if you want to play with that, you can definitely do 1, 2, 3, sandwich back. 1, 2, 3, sandwich back. 1, 2, 3. Here you push through, incorporate, then cross out in front and walk. But you see, it's very important to have extension. Extension of your leg, extension of your leg, extension of your leg. So then you have the power to reach and grab your partner's foot.
And we do it again here so they can see we are not so much in the corner.
One. Look how Eva is keeping this foot, this leg straightened and the foot's pointed so I can slide my foot in there. Cross, 2. Notice here my cross body.
Yeah.
This allows me to make her pivot and then I pivot myself. See, now I'm here. She's about to transfer her weight, but with this hand here, I am holding her so I prevent her from going too far. Then when I want her to unload her weight, she will unload and continue. Which brings me back now to the second part of the movement. 1, 2, and 3. So let's do a little break for water, and we continue. Let me give you 2 important things.
Yes. So this is the moment to talk about your help. And so if you like what you see, our classes, you can contribute to make a donation to Venmo or PayPal, as you can see in the screen right now. We appreciate it a lot. Thank you so much for supporting us all this time. And we will be looking forward to keep sharing with you what we know about Tango. Okay, so yeah, make your donation if you can. If you cannot, you can share, like, subscribe, anything.
Tell your friends to make a donation.
Tell your friends to make a donation, Patricio. We can keep coming every week here to the studio and dance what we love to dance, which is tango.
Very nice. Okay. So the other thing is the second part of the movement. So far we have 1, 2, 3. Now this is a double step, so the follow will do and 4.
Yes.
Now there are different ways to enter this movement. All you need is your partner doing a front cross towards your right. Front cross towards my right side, that is clockwise. Position 1. Pivot. Position 2. You see, I'm looking for my partner here. Position 3. And 4. If it's too hard to put the foot here in front of her foot, see, right foot with right foot. If it's too hard to go in here, you can step out here. And it will be the same thing. Position 5. On the inside.
I mean, on the outside of my foot.
Inside of mine, yeah.
Position six. If I do position six, I have to do seven and eight. There are several observations, several facts about this movement, about this turn. One, two, three, and four, five, six, and seven, eight. And that's it. So four, five, and six are another set of three unique positions, followed by seven and eight. I'd like to simplify and tell my students to do a media luna, because you're doing backside forward. It is a media luna right there after six.
To finish.
Yes.
Okay, yeah.
So I want to do two things. I want to bring the top view.
Nice.
So because this is beautiful to see from the top.
Yes.
So if our director can do a little camera switch. Voila.
Ah, we are there.
Oops. Okay. Hello. So front ocho. One, two, three, and four, five, six, seven, eight. Eight is one. Do you see this?
So yeah,
it's a circle.
Yeah, exactly. So. We need to show that every position is different, as you say, and then you repeat at the end, right? So this
one,
position is different from
two,
this position, from this position.
Three. And
from
four.
That position.
Five.
And that position.
Left foot. My left foot is inside her right foot. Six. See here, I maintain my partner in the front, because if she goes back right away, we will be on the same side of the hemisphere and we'll lose balance. We need to stay on opposite side of the circle. Seven and eight.
And this is again number one.
Being one. Yes.
We already did that. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Correct.
One more time?
Yes.
I know people are doing it at home. One, two, three, and four, five, six, and seven, eight.
Good.
And now a close-up of this part of the body,
okay.
Our favorite part of the body.
Mm-hmm. Let's see.
Dancing feet. And one, two, slow her down, three. See, I slow her down before she transfer her weight. Transfer weight. And four, pivot, five, six. This is the beginning of media luna. When you reach outside here, and she will go six and seven, front ocho, eight. You do this so well, Eva.
Thank you. You too.
One, two, three, and four, five, six, and seven. This is a special request from Bruce and Denise. They say, Patricio, we want to see Mingo's turn. I learned this from one of my instructors, one of my maestros, my teacher, Mingo Pugliese, a long time ago. I was so young. I was 21 years old. I used to go up to the tower of the church. Mingo Pugliese was the housekeeper of a church in Avenida Caseros, in the old town of Buenos Aires. And to go take a private lesson with him, you needed to go to the church and knock on the door, and he would come out from a little door on the side, let you in, and you needed to go to the tower. And by the time you were in the staircase, you were wondering what you were getting yourself into. And then Mingo would be at the top, and then you have a great lesson. And I remember I learned this system. It was mind-blowing at the time. I couldn't have grasped, understand what this was about. But it takes a little while. For some, even more than others, but it takes a little while to understand. But once you get a feel for this turn, it's fantastic enabler. It makes figures and steps and combinations flow, so the improvisation is much more fluid and spontaneous. So I'm very grateful to Mingo and his family for teaching me this long time ago. You also took lessons with Mingo, right?
Yes, yes. So I know the place you're talking about. Yes, I've been there, yes.
All right. It was the Tango Church.
Yes.
A little bit like what we have here. I feel like this is our temple of tango here in the studio.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, of course.
So, we have the whole thing already, yes?
Yes, I would like to talk to the followers about one particular step in the molinete that sometimes we don't pay much attention to and it's very important. So, that is the side step. The side step, sometimes we, for some reason, we shorten the side step. So, we alter the length of that step. And it makes us be kind of uneven what we are doing. So every time you go to a side step, in these particular turns that we are doing now, okay, so take this like with a grain of salt, depending on what you do always, but in this, it's just a molinete, like a plain molinete. So what I want to say is that after, this usually is easier to understand the side step and to go for a longer step, but even this side step, sometimes ladies have a tendency to do it very short, okay? So you want to project that leg, change your way. And after you do that, because side front is a quick, I feel like that's why ladies start doing a very short step and they give priority to the front step. So what I will say is I will kind of hop, not really hopping through the air, but I will kind of propel myself and push myself to that side step with a little more energy to accomplish a nice side step. Okay, so you need to engage your body to do it this way. So after I go for the back step here, I give a nice side step as the rest of the steps, okay? So we are talking about establishing a particular kind of length. I'm not dancing milonguero very small around. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about what we are doing today. So I will show you in action with Patricio. And I will just say like there, something like that, so you know where. There. There. You saw that? One more time.
Front ocho, we go.
There. Sorry. Okay? This. Instead of this very small step there, because then
yes.
we get away. What happens is that we put our foot so close that the next step is the one that we are going to have problems with, okay? You know, the actual step that was wrong, but what follows, okay? So I show you. I do the same thing, just for them to register what I'm doing. There. There. So, what am I doing here from the back step? First of all, what I don't do is go straight to the diagonal. Because my partner is there, I will hit him. Okay? So, when I'm doing that, I go in an L shape very quickly. So, I'm here in the back, let's say, and I will do that. I will do shoop. So I don't completely collect, I don't stop there, nothing. But what I do is I kind of do a quick L movement to be sure that I don't crash with his legs when I'm doing that, okay? So I will say again there, and you pay attention technically what I'm doing. There. There. Yes? Right? What do you think? You like it like that?
I love it.
Okay.
I have to do the same thing.
Hmm.
Three.
This.
And four. I get out of the way. So it's kind of like the idea behind the symbol of the yin-yang, mm-hmm. where you see the white moving, circling around the white, and both hover into each other like that. Mm-hmm. Like this. Two turning, we turn around each other with a center, empty center. Mm-hmm. So as we both stay away out of the center, on after the side step, see, Eva pivots, I go, she goes side, side, forward with the same foot. Eva transfer weight, but we're both taking a rectangular shape, more or less, you see? Like that. We both allow for each other to pass through.
Yes, and I want to just show you, so it's pragmatic for you to see what happens if you don't, okay? I will show a small step. Like, it gets very crowded in our legs. If I do a small step, it starts getting kind of crowded. I don't give enough room for him to enter into a sacada there. Like, we start getting too close in
the footwork. That's correct. Yes. The
so
circle.
Maybe you didn't see it there. Maybe it kind of even looked like, it's kind of okay for me, you know?
You make it look good even when you don't do it right.
I don't know. But in the energy between the couple, it's not the best. It feels like in the edge of failing, right?
Yes. That's a very good point. And then there is something important as well to remember is the syncopations. So the syncopations are on four and five. Three and four. Five, six, and seven. See, in those two places, the follow takes a quick, slow, and the lead takes a collection forward. Mm-hmm. So I go one, two, three, and four. Five, six, and seven. You see, on the end, first time, I collected. I have to respect that tempo, so it matches yours, because you take two steps. Mm-hmm. And I also have to pivot on the seven and six and seven.
Yes.
Let's do it one more time. Okay. Those were you do one, two, three, and four, five, six, and seven. See, here my hand is stopping her so she does a front ocho, for example. Mm-hmm. Or if I want to continue, I will go seven, eight, which is two. So if you want to do more than one time eight, you can do that as well.
Very good.
I think this is a lot of information, huh? These people can have fun for several sessions. Mm-hmm. Let's dance?
Yes, let's dance. Venía si te escuchan.
Gracias, amor mío. No dijimos una palabra en español hoy.
Un poquito, bueno.
Ok, nos vemos la semana que viene, amigos. Gracias por estar con nosotros hoy aquí.
Eso. Muchas gracias. See you next week. Thank you so much. Bye.